Friday night baseball under the dome at Tropicana Field. Tonight we continue the road trip with the first of three between the Oakland A's and the Tampa Bay Rays. Major League Baseball on the show starts now. Digging in now, Steve Lombardozzi. He'll get us started in this one under the lights.
Second baseman, Steve Lombardozzi.
Here's the first pitch to him. Underway now on a Friday night as the first pitch of our series misses for ball one. Can't get around quick enough, and that'll move the count to 1-1. The 1-2. Misses ball two.
Don't be surprised if he gets another back foot slider right here. Don't think for a second just because he took the first one that this pitcher won't come back exactly the same way.
And there's one away. Here's Jed Lowry now. Head to head against Chris Archer. He's 1-for-4.
Jed Lowry.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Comes right after him with a fastball for a strike. Fastball that just misses inside.
That's the kind of pitch that reminds me of many reasons why I wasn't a very good hitter. This thing was inside and coming in hot, and he just gave a stone-cold take. I'm bailing out of the way if I'm in the box, no doubt about it.
And a slider runs in on him as he has to lean out of the way. And here's a changeup in there for a called third strike, and that's the second out of the inning. That'll bring up the power hitter, Matt Olson. It was a two-hit effort for him, including a home run in last night's game. Here's a two-seamer inside to start the at-bat. It's 1-0. High in the air out to center field. Kiermaier's got a read on it. And that retires the side. Stepping into the box, Brad Miller. He'll lead things off here in the bottom half of the first.
Right fielder, Brad.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. And he'll try to crowd him there to start the at-bat. It's 1-0. Changeup stays outside, and he's behind 2-0.
Boy, he just looks locked in at the plate right now to me. His numbers in recent games have been very good, and those were two stone-cold takes right there that put himself in a great hitter's count.
2-1 to the Rays' leadoff batter. All even now, 2-2. The 2-2. Swing and a little tapper. That ball's foul, so a good job to fight it off and stay alive. To the right side, and that is through into right field for a single. So it's a good start to the inning for the Rays as their leadoff hitter is aboard. So striding forward now, Kevin Kiermaier. From the belt, kicks and deals, fouled off. Miller on at first, nobody out. The 0-1 pitch. And that one just missed outside. Mingdon, a native Texan. He was a fourth-round selection during the 2014 draft.
Hey, when you come out of the middle rounds, you have to grind for everything, and that's exactly what this guy has done, and he has turned himself into a solid big league ball player.
Here's the 1-2 delivery. Now the fastball is right by him as he swings and misses for the first out of the inning.
Batting third.
The plate now is the designated hitter, Matt Duffy. Matt first chance Duffy. For him here with a runner at first and one gone. First delivery to him on the way. Sends that one out of play for strike one. The 0-1 on its way. Very weakly on the ground. Here comes the 0-2 pitch. Missed with a slider.
That's back-to-back breaking balls away, but now he's got himself into a little bit of a tough spot. You probably can't throw that again, so your opponent is probably up there just looking for a fastball that he can drill.
Runner at first here, one man out. The 1-2 gets him looking, strike three. So next to the plate for Tampa Bay, Ryan Schimpf. Three hits for him in that ball game on Wednesday. From the stretch, here's the pitch. A changeup over the inside corner.
Well, if you could throw it for a strike consistently, a first-pitch changeup is effective. Hitters are almost never looking for it.
Now a half swing here on the pitch inside, but it's a full swing in the eyes of the home plate umpire. Strike two. Working for the punch-out and the offering. Strike three called as he can't get the bat off his shoulders. Side retired. Now at the plate, Boog Powell will stand in against Chris Archer to get the inning underway. First delivery to him on the way. And that misses inside, 1-0. Powell, a California-born ball player. He was a 20th-round selection during the first-year player draft of 2012.
Hey, this guy's got a chance to be an absolute steal. Being drafted where he was, there are definite signs that he has a chance to make an impact at the big league level.
Nope.
And inside. He takes one off the inside corner for ball two. Liner toward right center. And that will be the first hit for the Athletics thus far. Here's Chris Davis now. A couple of hits for him in four trips to the plate last night. First pitch on its way. And a fastball just below the knees, ball one. One and one the count. Nobody out, runner on first. Hit fairly well out towards straightaway center. Kiermaier's got a read on it. One down. Coming to the plate now, Matt Joyce. First swings for him in this one with a runner still at first and one gone. Here's the first pitch to him. And the changeup is way low that time.
The intent with that changeup away was one thing and one thing only. Get a double play ball. Nice job to lay off it at the plate, though.
Line drive, base hit. Now to the plate, Josh Begley. He's back in the starting lineup for this one after sitting out last night's game. Comes set. Here's the nothing and nothing pitch. Good changeup that time, but he wouldn't bite on it. Way out in front. Check swing, no swing, says the home plate umpire. Ball two.
Boy, he better get it back together here quick because he's got two guys on already. He's starting to lose location of that strike zone. He's got to throw a strike right here.
3-1 to him now. Full count, 3-2. In front of a fastball as this is ripped down the left field line. That's going to be a fair ball. And he's in safely at third as they jump ahead with a run scoring on the play. Ready now, Roberto Garcia, as he'll get his first opportunity in this one. Here comes the first pitch. A high fastball is in there. Swing and a ground ball to third. Only play is going to be to first, so score it as an RBI ground out as the lead moves to 2-0 now. And that brings up Chad Pinder, runner in scoring position with Sujan. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. First pitch fastball off the plate there, and it's ball one. Fastball right down the middle for a strike.
You know, I think this is a big situation in this game. They've got to lead by a couple of runs, but they don't want to look back on this inning when this one's over and think that they left some runs out there on the base path. Scoring more here would be huge.
Swung on and missed, and that's the final out of the inning. Here's C.J. Crone now. It was an 0-for-4 effort for him in Wednesday's ball game.
Hey, we're still in the early stages in this one. They're only down by a couple of runs. But it's really key for this leadoff guy to try to get on and get a big inning started.
There's a strike. Popped him up. Pinder is there. One away. So one away here with the bases empty. And standing in the speedy Carlos Gomez. First offering on its way. And the breaking ball stays outside. A high pop-up. Olsen has room in foul territory. Two down. Here's Echevarria now. We'll try to make something happen with two gone in the bottom of the second.
Echevarria.
First pitch of the at-bat. And that one right down Main Street.
Hey, that's another nice two-seamer right there. He's been able to manipulate that pitch all game, keeping it at the hollow of the knee, getting a lot of ground balls and a lot of swing and miss.
Ball one. Had him off stride that time, and it's 1-2.
Hey, that's a really good pitch right there, and that's one of those off-balance swings. As a pitcher, you want to look in and say, howdy, if you're waving at me. A real ugly swing, and it gives you a lot of confidence when you make a guy look that bad.
And we'll have to leave it there as the play is made here to end the inning. Standing in, Steve Lombardozzi, as we are all set to begin the third inning in this one.
One of the keys to securing a win, they want to keep the pressure on and try to build that lead as much as they can moving into the later innings.
Rolled slowly to first. Home takes it in, and he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Digging in, Jed Lowry. First time up, he went down looking. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And a fastball just a bit up. And that one stayed too low, apparently.
Remember, he was a strikeout victim last time up, but this at-bat seems to be a totally different direction. He's showing good patience now, and he's got a real good count at 2-0.
3-0 to him now. 3-0 pitch. It's laid off, but in there for strike one. Swing, strike two.
Yeah, Matty, not only is this guy using all four quadrants, he's elevating, getting their eye level up with a quality fastball.
And that's a swinging strike three in the dirt. And the throw is in time. Lowry is retired, two down now. Stepping in and ready for another shot, Matt Olson. He flew out in his last at-bat. First pitch on its way. A ball and no strikes. And that's high and away, and the count goes to 2-0. Now the 2-0. Pulls this one into the air out into right field. Miller is there. And that's the third out. Up next for the Rays, Jesus Sucre, as we move on to the bottom of inning number three.
Jesus Sucre.
Ready. Here's the first offering. And that pitch catches the inside corner. Sucre, the former Seattle Mariner, he was acquired via trade last year.
I know he'd tell you he'd like to be playing a little bit better, but I think it's as advertised for this ball club right now. I think the manager is getting exactly what they expected.
Hey, that's obviously the game plan against this guy. Bury it in on his hands. He finds himself down 0-2 now. He doesn't know if he's coming back in there or going breaking stuff down the way.
And that's high for a ball. It's 2-2.
Kind of pitching him backwards in this AB. Soft stuff early. Then those last two were fastballs, trying to get it right by him.
And it's fouled away. The 2-2 one more time. Soft liner towards short. A dare to take it is Lowry, as he was well positioned for out number one. Into the box now, Micah Johnson. The average for him entering play, not far north of 200. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. Looks at a changeup right over the middle.
Watching him on the mound, I'm really impressed with what he's doing right now. He's been really aggressive and confident over the last couple of innings.
High in the air out to center field. Howell's under it. Two gone. In now, Brad Miller. He singled his last time up.
Brad Miller.
Here comes the first pitch. Ball hit high and foul down the left field line. It's strike one. Nothing in one count. Here it comes. A fastball right over the outside corner. Back up the middle. Lowry's got it. Throw to first will get him easily, and the side is retired. Striding in once again, Boog Powell. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one. Here's the first pitch to him. Takes a fastball on the inside corner.
Quite an interesting outing up to this point as we head into the middle innings. He's pitching quite well, but you look at his first pitch strike percentage, less than 40%. That's going to be something he's going to need to clean up moving forward.
No offer on that one. Two balls and a strike. And this is on the inside edge, perhaps off the inside edge, but it's a called strike. 2-2 now. This is on the ground over to first. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the out. Coming to the plate now, Chris Davis. So far, 0-1 with a flyout. Infield in the overshift here. Now the pitch. And here's a fastball called for strike one. Chased out of the zone there, and he's down two strikes.
Welcome to my world right here, batter. I've seen this 0-2 count way too many times.
There's a swing and a drive, and everybody's just going to sit back and watch that one fly. A no-doubt home run. Here's Matt Joyce now. He singled and scored in his first appearance in this one.
Matt Joyce.
First pitch of the at-bat. The fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0. That swung on and missed. We're even at 1-1.
Classic case right there of an off-speed pitch, and that hitter's eyes lit up, and that front shoulder went flying.
To right field and absolutely hammered. Forget about making a play on that ball. It's way out of here. Back-to-back home runs.
Now
trying to pick things up where he left off. Josh Begley. RBI double is what he was credited with his first time around. Belt high and right down the middle for a strike. Fegley, 30 years of age. He was a first-round pick back in the 2009 MLB draft.
Yeah, he has turned himself into a really nice ball player. I wouldn't put him on the superstar level, but you know what? They didn't miss with this pick either. You go in the high rounds and you carve out a career the way this guy has, nice pick.
One ball and two strikes to the A's catcher. Line toward right center. That's in another base hit. He's 2-for-2. Next up for the A's, Roberto Garcia. 0-for-1 with a run batted in thus far. First pitch coming. Here it is. And he fouls this one off. Swing and a miss on the slider, and he's quickly behind, nothing and two. Pitch is mishandled behind the plate, and it bounces away. And he'll make it in easily at second, as I'd imagine that'll be scored a passed ball. Look out. That one almost got away from him. 2-2 now.
Well, giving up hits is one thing, but judging by that last pitch, he doesn't have any consistency with his release point right now. He doesn't know where it's going, and he knows it.
Line drive to center field. That's in there. Base hit. And the runner from second will stay put at third, so their runners at the corners now with one away. Now at the plate, Chad Pinder, and their runners at the corners now. First delivery to him on the way. Tough slider down low for a strike.
First and third, you know he's going to do everything he can on the mound to roll up a double play ball. On the other side, he's got to be looking for a mistake up in the zone that he can drive in the air and pick up a sac fly at the very least.
Runners off for second. Here's a pop-up now.
Home.
Takes charge, and he's got it. Two down. On to first, a double play. Stepping up to the plate, Kevin Kiermaier. He was a strikeout victim in his first try.
Lots of baseball left in this one as we're still early on, but you don't want to fall too far behind. They're already down by a bundle, and one of the things you want your leadoff guy to get on and set the table for the big boys to start driving in some runs.
And that'll get on through into left for a leadoff single. But the plate now for the Rays is the DH, Matt Duffy. He'll look to bounce back after striking out his last time up. And prior to the first pitch, he'll look to first. Runner back safely. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Takes a look at a strike over the inside corner.
These are the moments in the game that can sway it one way or another why you get a W or a loss right here. Leadoff man on, heart of the order coming up. Guy out on the mound, this guy's work cut out.
And that's a base hit. One for two in his first couple of plate appearances. And he is in there. Next to bat will be the Tampa Bay cleanup hitter, Ryan Schimpf, comes into this at bat 0 for 1 in the ballgame. Set and the pitch. Missed with a breaking ball.
Well, they've yet to hang a number on the scoreboard, but it looks like they've got a great opportunity from the breakthrough. Going to be pretty demoralizing if they can.
Popped him up. Lombardozzi is there for it. Looks it into his glove, and there's one gone. So digging in now, C.J. Cron. He's got runners at the corners here with only one gone.
C.J. Cron.
First delivery to him on the way. Swing, line drive. That's going to be trouble. One run will score easily. Here's the second runner around third. He comes across to score as it's now a two-run game. Stepping in, Carlos Gomez. His last at-bat didn't go his way as he popped out in foul territory. First pitch coming. Here it is. Donnie extends nicely, and this ball is driven to right field and deep. And it's gone. Here's Echeverria now.
Now batting the first off, Jamie Echeverria.
First offering on its way. A swing and a miss, and that's what you call establishing the inside part of the plate with strike one. A windup and the 0-2 pitch. And a wasted pitch there, 1-2.
Not a bad pitch right there on 0-2, a fastball. And I think as a hitter right now, you have to continue to go up there looking to hit off the fastball.
Had him fooled as he swings through the curveball. Two down. Into the box, Jesus Sucre. Hit it hard but lined out in his first at-bat. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. This is is taken outside for ball one.
He was able to foul that one off, but you could tell he was definitely late. That breaking ball, the pitch before that heater right there, definitely threw his timing off.
Fouled away. Four runs here in this half inning. This pitch is popped up. Fegley is there, and he puts it away to stop the bleeding. So the lineup flips over and digging in, Steve Lombardozzi. He's hitless in his two at-bats so far. First pitch of the at-bat. And a neck-high fastball that time. This is pulled into right. But this is right at him in right field as he hardly has to move to take it in for the first down. Jed Lowry now. No hits to this point. First pitch on its way. Almost a worm burner as he misses on a low fastball. Ball one. Takes a look at one catching the outside corner. Line drive caught by Echevarria. And they're certainly hitting the ball hard enough, just not finding any holes here. Two away now. Ready for another shot now. Matt Olson, 0 for 2 for him to this point. Here's the first pitch to him. There's a knee-high pitch that catches the zone.
Hey, two outs, nobody on, and a power hitter up. This is where, as a pitcher, you got to use the hitter's aggression against him. Get him to fish a little bit. Something a little more out of the zone than normal.
2-1 to the A's first baseman.
I'm sure he's frustrated by that call. Probably could have been a strike, but at the same time, earning strikes from the umpire is a real thing. If you've been all over the place like he has, you're just not going to get much help from the umpire.
2-2 count. Here it comes. Down the first baseline. And he'll step on the bag himself, and the inning is over. Here now is Micah Johnson as we move past the halfway point in this one and begin the bottom of the fifth. Here comes the first pitch. There's a fastball that just misses. Ball one. Sharp slider that time. Just missed inside. A fastball right down the middle for a strike.
You know, he fell behind 2-0, Matty, but he battled right there and got right back in this count. An aggressive fastball middle of the zone.
Pulled toward right center field. Howell's under it. And that's the first out of the inning. Digging in once again, Brad Miller. He singled in two trips to the plate thus far.
Miller.
Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Slider's in for a strike.
Oh, he thanks his lucky stars right there getting away with that hanger. I cannot believe he didn't pull the trigger on that pitch.
And he misses with it. 1-1. Hit high and deep to right center. Giving chase is Powell. And he makes the catch for the second out. Standing in, Kevin Kiermaier.
Center fielder, Kevin Kiermaier.
And the pitch.
That's a
fastball here as he'll take a look at ball one. 1-0.
This guy's one of the best bunters in the league, but with two outs, I'm not sure that's a really good play right now. He might be forced to go ahead and swing the bat and try to get an extra base hit here with two outs.
A ball and a strike now. Hit hard on the ground to the right. And this will get through into right, and he's aboard with a single. So now with two away, the middle of the order gets to bat with opportunities on base.
Up next for Tampa Bay.
Next will be the designated hitter, Matt Duffy. Matt he scored after Duffy. Reaching on a single in his last time up. First offering on its way. A changeup over the inside corner.
It might be time for this guy to start mixing his pitches up a little bit better. He's pitching poorly, but if you look at his first pitch strike percentage at over 70%, this team batting has a pretty good idea what his game plan is.
Two quick strikes, and now the 0-2 lifted into the air out towards center field. Powell's under it, and that's the third out. So now it'll be the four-hole hitter, Luke Powell. He got on top of one and was a ground-out victim last time. First pitch of the at-bat on its way. Back to the mound and off his leg. But he is able to recover as he gets the out at first. One away now. Here's Chris Davis now. 1-for-2 in the ballgame thus far. First pitch coming. Here it is. Tough slider down low for a strike. Takes a high fastball for a strike.
Pretty unusual that you see a 5-0 hitter take two strikes in a row. Typically, those are some of the most aggressive batters in the lineup.
Scooped up on the backhand. And the sixth inning is progressing quickly here. Now two away. And it doesn't look like the manager fully agrees with that out call at first. It appears he may opt to challenge it and have the play reviewed.
Well, I think we're going to have to wait and see what the word is from the dugout. But here's another look at it. Wow. Tough to tell if he was out for certain from that angle. I can see why this was a really tough call for the umpire.
So here's the signal from the bench, and they will indeed ask for the play to be reviewed. So the umpires will get on the horn with the replay operations center in Manhattan and attempt to get a definitive answer on this play.
The Athletics are challenging.
All right, we'll take one last look at it here. The question is there enough video evidence to change the call to safe? And wow, from that look at it, I think he did beat that throw. This challenge might work out for him.
The decision appears to have been made as the headset comes off, and the runner is safe. So the call is overturned. The runner will stay at first base, and they maintain the right to challenge further plays going forward. Here's Matt Joyce now as he looks at a fastball that's in there for strike one. Two hits and two trips for him thus far.
It'll be interesting to see if they use that changeup in this at-bat. That last at-bat, that was a changeup he hit for a home run. I'm going to see if this time they don't go to more fastballs and curveballs.
And he's safe. Pulled toward right center field. On the move is Kiermaier. He hauls it in without any trouble, and there are two away. And no tag a second. He'll head back there with two away now.
Up next for
digging in and looking for more, Josh Begley. He doubled earlier and carries a 2-for-2 line into this appearance. He's ready. Here's the first offering. Missed with a slider. left side. Chimp scoops it up. And the throw pulls the first baseman off the bag, and he'll reach it first. Jose De Leon trots in from the bullpen here as he inherits a tough spot with two on and two away.
Your attention, please. This change for the Rays. Now playing right field, number 13, Brad Miller.
Roberto Garcia will be the first one to greet him now, as he'll do so with runners at the corners and two out in the inning. Here's the first pitch to him. And here's a slider that's nowhere close, and it's 1-0. De Leon, a native of Puerto Rico. He was a 24th round selection back in the draft of 2013.
Hey, this guy's got a chance to be an absolute steal. Being drafted where he was, there are definite signs that he has a chance to make an impact at the big league level.
3-0 now. 4-4 is our score as we play the sixth. And he'll just make him throw one over here. 3-1.
3-1 with two on, and this is where you got to be geared up for something to drive. I don't think you can just move him one right here. You still have to try to make a competitive pitch.
He's set, and the payoff pitch. High in the air out to center field. Kiermaier's got a read on it. He hauls it in, and the potential go-ahead run will not come around to score. Next will be the cleanup hitter, Ryan Schimpf. It was a flyout for him in his last trip.
Third baseman, Ryan Schimpf.
First delivery to him on the way. Fouled off. On its way, the 0-1 pitch. Whoa. Missed with a breaking ball. Swing and a miss way behind the big fastball.
I know that fastball registered at about 92, 93, but I guarantee you it looked about 4 to 5 miles an hour faster than that for this offensive player. After coming off a curveball, the old push the throttle and pull it is being used.
Into the windup, here comes the 2-2 pitch. And it's fouled away. The 2-2 one more time. Again, he sends it out of play. Swing, and he went around, says the home plate umpire. Tough ruling, but it's out number one. Here's CJ Krohn now, 1-for-2 with a double on his line thus far. First pitch coming, here it is. And a changeup right down the middle.
If I'm on the mound right now, I know I'm in the hitter's head. He was definitely sitting soft. I might speed him up and elevate it right here.
high and deep to right center. And he will make the play out there, and there are two away now.
Up next,
stepping in, Carlos Gomez. A hit in two tries for him so far.
And hey, it was a breaking ball to boot. This guy's a pretty good off-speed hitter. You could tell by that last at-bat, he wasn't fooled at all. He sat back, waited, got the breaking ball, and didn't miss it.
And a fastball's in there for strike one. Four runs, six hits, one error in the ballgame for Tampa Bay. Swing and a miss. He struck him out with a two-seamer, and the inning is over. Back here at Tropicana Field in St. Pete. Seventh inning straight ahead, but first let's take a look at the game summary for the first six innings of baseball. So coming to the plate, Chad Pinder. He was a double play victim last time around. First pitch on its way. Takes a knee-high fastball. Big tilt on the slider gets a swing and a miss. Hit down the third baseline, but this will be a foul ball, and it's still 0-2. Here comes another 0-2. Good waist pitch, 1-2. Hit out towards second, and that's through for a hit. So a good start to the inning for the A's as their leadoff hitter reaches base safely. Digging in, the switch hitter, Steve Lombardozzi, hit the ball pretty well in his last at-bat, but it resulted in a line out. First pitch of the at-bat, and a neck-high fastball that time. Fastball that just misses inside. Lifted down the line and left. But this one lands in the bullpen area, a foul ball. Now the 2-1 pitch. Flared to the right side. That'll do the job. It's in there, a base hit. Digging in to try it again, Jed Lowry. He could really use a knock here, 0-for-3 in the game so far. Here comes the first pitch. Line toward the alley in left center. And that's in there, base hit. And the go-ahead run will move up to third and wisely hold there with nobody out. Digging in, Matt Olson. He has a great opportunity now to break this tie, but I'd imagine at least the corners will be playing in here. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Comes right after him with a fastball for a strike. A changeup that just catches the bottom of the zone for a strike. There are two strikes now and a runner at first. Do you go for the strikeout, or are you still looking for the double play ball?
Well, Matt, I think a lot of it depends on the type of pitcher that you are. If you're a power pitcher, you can go ahead and ride a fastball up in the zone. But if you're a guy that induces a lot of ground balls with a sinker, I think you have to stick with that plan.
The next 0-2 misses, and that'll move it to 1-2 now.
Wow, kind of an interesting pitch call there. The batter flailed at the pitch away on the previous one, so you'd think you'd go right back.
Meanwhile, this ball gets down. It's a base hit. Notch one in the score column as a runner from third crosses the plate. It's a 5-4 game. Now at the plate, Luke Powell. And he's got an opportunity to add to this lead, but the double play is in order. Here's the first pitch to him. Takes a fastball on the inside corner. And there's one well above the zone for a ball.
This is where you got to empty the bucket out on the mound. Throw your best stuff right here, right now, and try and get out of this. If anything catches outfield grass, this game's probably over.
That ball's fast.
Needs a punch out here. Can he get it? Yes, he can. A swing and a miss, and that's a big out number one. Here's Chris Davis now. He was retired via the ground ball last time up. First pitch on its way. There's a swing and a drive hit well out to right field. Miller looking up. Gone! It's a grand slam.
Now pitching for the Rays.
So they'll make a matchup move here and bring on a southpaw to face the left-handed hitter due up. Matt Joyce will be the first one to greet him as he'll start fresh here with the bases empty following the home run.
Matt Joyce.
Infield shifted well to the right. Here's the first pitch. And he takes ball one. A ball and a strike. Still only one out in the inning. And this is taken for a called strike. Oh, that's a tough call. Now one and two. Lays off the 1-2 changeup, and he's worked it back to 2-2. And struck him out. Settling in now, Josh Fegley. 2-for-3 with a double on his line so far. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. And that one right down Main Street. A wave and a miss. A tick behind a good fastball.
It's amazing. I tell so many fans, you get in a box one time, the one pitch you're going to swing at more than any other is that elevated fastball. Your eyes light up as an offensive player, and you just cannot get to it.
Breaking ball, and he gets him to chase it in the dirt. The throw to first is in time, and the inning is over.
It's time for the traditional seventh inning stretch.
Now batting, Adani Echevarria. He comes in 0-for-2 thus far.
It doesn't look very promising so far in this one as we move into later innings. Down by a bundle, it's time to get some base runners and hopefully a long ball to get them back into this one.
High pop-up. Olsen over to his right. He's got it one away. At the plate, Jesus Sucre. It's been an 0-for-2 effort for him to this point.
Sucre.
First pitch of the at-bat. And here's a called strike at the knees. Don't think he liked that one too much, but it's 0-1. Back up the middle. And into center field as he's aboard with a one-out single. Striding into the box, Micah Johnson, 0-for-2, and he's blown out twice.
Micah Johnson.
Now time is called as both guys in the bullpen are ready to go.
Your attention, please.
Now so they'll go to the bullpen now, and it'll be the left-hander here to face the upcoming left-handed batter. Ready to deliver. Here's the first pitch. Takes a fastball on the inside corner. Now a ball lined to the left side. But this is a foul ball. in under the hands with a fastball. It's 1-2. Now another 1-2. And another foul ball. The 1-2 is a swing and a miss. That's strike three. So Tampa's batting order turns over, set to go. Brad Miller, he's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Here's the first pitch to him. High in the air and drifting out to shallow center. Howell's on his horse. He's there to make the play, and that'll retire the side. So striding in, Roberto Garcia.
Now for Oakland, designated hitter, Roberto Garcia.
First pitch of the at-bat on its way. And he'll start in with a fastball that misses down and away for a ball, 1-0. With this one almost in books, the story was clearly the long ball. What are your thoughts on this offense, fellas?
Well, Matty V, I don't know what your thoughts are, D-World, but boy, when the weather starts to warm up and the ball starts jumping out like this, it's clear that the pitchers need to start making better pitches.
Yeah, just great approach. No one really chased today. Really stayed staunch on their ability to get that pitcher to come into the heart of the plate, and they did that.
Here comes the first pitch. And a curveball that started low and broke lower, ball one. Fastball stays way up that time for ball two.
That was a non-competitive pitch right there, and he finds himself behind 2-0 in this.
A swing and a drive sent out toward the gap. But that'll hit off the wall in left center. Around second now and headed for third. The relay throw, but he is in there with a triple.
Now back.
Digging in, Steve Lombardozzi. He comes into this appearance in the midst of a 1-for-4 day. From the stretch. There's a strike. It is career. Lombardozzi is carrying a slugging percentage under 350. Needless to say, he's not a big extra base hitter home run guy right here. He'll try to bunt his way on as he gets this one down. And he'll take it to the bag himself for the second out. But meanwhile, the run is in to score. Jed Lowry now. First delivery to him on the way. Curveball that time, not even close. Hit on the ground out to short. That gets through and he'll reach base again on his second base hit of the game. So the two-out hit keeps the top of the eighth inning extended. Now in the box, Matt Olson. It was an RBI single for him in his last plate appearance. He's set. Here it comes. Takes a look down at the knees for a strike. Down the left field line and deep. And that will end up a foul ball. The 0-2 home. And certainly no offer at that one. It's 1-2. Smoked on the ground up the middle. That's through for a base hit. His second of the ball game. So that'll bring in the outfielder, Boog Powell. He went down on strikes last time up. First pitch coming. Here it is. Breaking ball. That's in the dirt as he takes a ball.
Got to believe the manager didn't have this in mind when he went to the bullpen. This reliever's got to step up right here. It's starting to tickle a little bit after getting hit around early.
That one's going to find the seats. Strike one. Popped him up. Schimpf shading to his right. And that ends the inning. Standing in, Kevin Kiermaier. He'll see what he can do leading
and
off the home eight.
For the center fielder, Kevin Kiermaier.
First pitch on its way. Swing and a drive to right. There it goes. And this one is gone. A home run. Striding forward now is the DH. Matt Duffy is working on a 1-for-3 thus far.
Duffy.
Trying to pitch here in the eighth with nobody out.
Number 39, Blake Trinan.
Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. First pitch is chopped foul at the plate at strike one. Into the windup, here comes the 0-1. Soft liner to the right side, and a step on first for the out, three unassisted. So stepping in, Ryan Schimpf. One run in and one gone so far this inning. Here's the first pitch to him. A shot down the first baseline. And he'll step on first for the out, three unassisted. Here's C.J. Krohn now. He's got a hit in three at-bats to this point. Ready with the first pitch. Here it comes. There's a fastball right over the inside corner. Back up. Oh, no, that got him. Fortunately, he's able to stick with it and get the out at first, and that'll put an end to the inning. Alex Colome comes on to work now, and he's their usual closer, but this is obviously not a save opportunity.
Yeah, and this is all about just getting him some work, guys. He hasn't had a chance to come in and close a game out for several days now, so they're just hoping they can keep him sharp and give him the chance to pitch in a real game situation here.
Now with the play, Chris Davis. He'll try and lead things off here in inning number nine.
Listen, it's not easy coming back off the closers, but this guy hasn't been super dependable so far this season. And he's blown several saves up to this point.
Ninth inning begins as the first pitch is taken for ball one. As we near the end of this one, it's clear the long ball has played a big role in today's outcome. Dan Dero, what are your final thoughts on what we've seen?
Yeah, just non-competitive pitches in some big situations, Dan, and the offense took full advantage.
Yeah, you know, D-Row, one of the things about pitching is you want to have location, and it was obvious in this one today that the pitchers weren't on point, and what happens when that happens? Hitters make you pay, and the long ball was a big part of this one here.
D-Row.
Two balls and two strikes, the count to Chris Davis. Changeup misses, and it's full 3-2.
Looked to me like he tried to do way too much on that 2-2 pitch. You don't have to come into the zone on that count, but a pitch that far outside isn't going to tempt anyone to swing.
Hit sharply on the ground. A diving try, but he can't haul it in. It's through for a base hit. Here's Matt Joyce now. In the past against Alex Colome, he's hitless in six tries. First delivery to him on the way. High fly ball out to straightaway center. Kiermaier's got a read on it. Makes the play, one away. Standing in, Josh Begley. He's doubled and singled in four at-bats in this contest. Here's the first pitch to him. hit to short, fielded by Hechevarria. There's one. Relay to first in time, and just like that, the side is retired. Riding in, Carlos Gomez, who was sat down on strikes in his last at-bat.
Left fielder.
First pitch of the at-bat. Try to check it, and it's 0-1. And that misses 1-1. And a slider misses here. Two balls and a strike.
Well, that's a good pitch, but you have to get a little bit closer to the plate than that. That's that big sweeping slider. If it was a little closer, you might get a swing.
Here now the 2-2. He's swung on and missed strike three. Here's Echevarria now. Career against Blake Treinen. He's only 2-for-10. First pitch on its way. Takes a look at one catching the outside corner. Behind 0-2 now. Bases are empty, one man up. Hit on the ground down the first baseline, but this will wind up foul, still 0-2. Pitch on the way. Turned on that one and crushed it, just pulled it a little foul. 0-2 once more. It's a wave and a miss. He struck him out. Ready for another chance? Jesus Sucre. He comes to the plate as the last chance for his side. Two out here in the ninth. Here's a cold strike about thigh high. Nothing in one. Now a changeup in on the hands that evens it at 1-1. Into the corner and slicing foul. Bases are empty here with two men out. Tampa down to their final strike in this one. So two balls and two strikes now. Grounded up the first baseline, but a foul ball as it holds it 2-2. And a tough take on an inside sinker that just missed for ball three.
Well, you don't want to get caught looking for the final out. That's a tough pitch to lay off. Impressive that he did.
Boy, really making him work now as the seventh pitch of the at-bat is also fouled away, so the count will hold steady at 3 balls and 2 strikes. And this one misses high for ball four, and they have themselves a two-out base runner.
How about it?
At the plate, Micah Johnson. He's hitless in 3 at-bats to this point. Here comes the first pitch. And that one just missed outside. So 1-1. Taking called strike two, and now they're down to their final strike tonight.
You got to throw that one out the window if you're an offensive player right now.
And this is a strike three called, and a bit of a questionable ending there as the ball game is over. Well, the lineup was clicking for him in this contest, and the man you see there was a major contributor. For that, he's the Topps player of the game.
Well, he blasted a couple of balls over the wall in this one.